I've been a fan of Dundalk for many years, and I've never felt like we had a proper chance about going up. And this year, I genuinely feel we do.
Since 2002, Dundalk FC have been in the footballing wilderness of Division 1 in the League of Ireland. Dundalk FC have a divine right to be among the top teams in the Republic of Ireland, because it goes without saying that this club is one of the country's most successful teams of all time. And to be playing with the top teams, Dundalk FC need to be in the top division. Will this be our year? Over the years, Dundalk FC have played host to many footballing giants in Oriel Park. Liverpool, Tottenham Hotspur, Porto, Celtic, Rangers, PSV Eindhoven, Manchester United and Ajax, to name but a few. Since our establishment in 1926, Dundalk FC have won a total of 48 trophies, and the hope is to make it 49 on the 15th of November by finally making it back to where we belong in the Premier Division. Oriel Park has had its fair share of exciting seasons over the decades, and this season of 2008 is definitely one of the most enthralling yet. As the league stands on the 24th of October with 4 matches remaining, the title is very much within Dundalk's reach, as it is for Shelburne and Waterford. Dundalk travel to the regional showgrounds in Waterford knowing they need 3 points to climb back to the summit of the league. After that ill-tempered match and the 3 points in the bag, Dundalk FC effectively ended Waterford's title hopes. And dealing with the arrival of Limerick 37 to Oriel Park was the next task in hand. After all the good work achieved in Waterford, a defeat to Limerick 37 would be unthinkable. And on the 30th of October, the penultimate home match for the Lilywhites commenced in front of a packed Oriel Park.
Oh,
Memorial Park was silenced by that goal from Paul Danaher just before half-time. Could that have been the end of it for Dundalk? As things stand, Shelburne are on top of the league by one single point, then Waterford are hot on the heels of Dundalk, 2 points behind. The heat was on, and the title was now very much Shelburne's to throw away.
Yeah, very comfortable. I think all the lads know the importance of the game, so hopefully we can do what we train all week to do.
Yeah, I think the most important thing for us is to get a result tonight, you know. Not to worry about the other team, the game tomorrow, like, you know, if we get a result, we know it goes into the last game of the season, you know.
We've had a long season. We played very, very well at the start of the season, you know. We're obviously in the last quarter, last series of games here, the business end of the season. And I think the players we have there, although we had a bad performance last week, might be, you know, the message we need to move forward tonight and make sure we win this game. It's one of the biggest games for the club in the last 5 or 6 years, so I think the players know that, you know.
Unfortunately, Shelburne also got the 3 vital points they needed in Waterford and now lead the table going into the final match. Dundalk face Kildare County and Station Road, while Shelburne face Limerick 37 and Talca Park. Fans travelled to Station Road in their hundreds, in hope rather than expectation.
Well, I came down more in sorrow than in hope, to be honest, because, you know, Shelburne with just one home game left and a point ahead. I mean, Dundalk threw it away over the year.
Yeah, well, I think it's out of our hands completely. You know, it's all down to what happens over there with Shells and Limerick. Limerick are capable of an upset. I mean, they did it against us. Why can't they do it against Shells? A draw or a loss for Shells would be ideal result for us, you know, and just do the business here.
I'm trying to be as sure as I can, but like I'm very nervous as well at the same time. We'll be looking at Shelburne's result, and it's just really is going to be very hard. Just, but we'll be, hopefully Limerick can get us this result and we'll be champions.
Fans flocked to Newbridge to support the famous Lily Whites, and they were hoping Limerick could do Dundalk a massive favour in Talca Park. Many fans were quite optimistic.
Yeah, I reckon actually we're going to win the league tonight. I don't want to disclose what my process is for, you know, coming to that conclusion.
Are we going to win
1-0 with 3 minutes of injury time left to play. As things stand, Shelburne are champions, and all the Dundalk fans can do is pray for a miracle.
Corner to Limerick, and the Limerick fans and the little group of them, about 20 or 30 of them, down behind Dean Delaney's goal there, the Shelburne goal. Now, is it written in the stars for Dundalk that there's going to be an equaliser here? Is there a final twist in this most dramatic of seasons? Corner to Limerick on the right, in it comes, deep into the box, up they rise there, the ball comes out to the edge of the box, and it's cleared by Shelburne on this occasion, but in it goes again. Onside here, Limerick, ball comes out, shot comes in, it's a goal for Limerick!
How I felt about the events that unfolded on the 15th of November.
Yeah.
Dundalk FC have made it 49 trophies in 82 years, and Colin Scanlon has become an unlikely hero around Dundalk. We asked Flano if he had anything to say to Colin.
Thank you very much.